Welcome into the Commander's Report. I am your host, Jack Sperry. Today, we are going to be talking about QBs. Specifically, is Sam Howell the guy, or maybe should he be the guy going into 2023? And if not, should they go after a trade for Lamar Jackson this offseason? It's going to be a juicy video. Let's start with Lamar Jackson for a little bit. Lamar Jackson is a superstar, bona fide superstar, quarterback in the National Football League. He's a former MVP. He's arguably the most electric runner of the football from the quarterback position in the league, and the Commanders are in win-now mode. Ron Rivera is arguably on the hot seat heading into 2023, so it makes sense that the Commanders might go all in on a guy like Lamar Jackson if he demands a trade out of Baltimore. Now, I'm going to be telling you a little bit more about Sam Howell and a potential trade package for Lamar Jackson in just one second, but before we get into that, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Right now, this channel, Commanders Report, is competing with three other chat sports channels that are brand new, and we are competing to see which channel gets the most subs. Whoever gets the most subscribers will get the full-time channel here at Chat Sports. So if you want a full-time Commanders channel here on YouTube, go ahead, click that subscribe button, tell your friends to subscribe, really rack up those subscribe numbers, guys, so we can get a full-time channel here for the Commanders. So now let's talk a little bit about Sam Howell. Sam Howell is somebody, you know, fifth round pick for the Commanders this past season. He played a little bit towards the end of the year in the Cowboys game, showed some pretty good things. But what I will say about Sam Howell in that game is that the Cowboys were really trying to conceal what they were going to be implementing in the playoffs. So they were pretty much running preseason style offense. Lots of country cover three, lots of easy coverages to break down, not a lot of shifting safeties, all these different things that Howell will have to beat if he's going to be a starter for the Commanders moving forward. So the success that he had in that game, I don't really take as, oh, he's for sure capable of being a starting quarterback. But what I saw from him at North Carolina when I broke him down for the draft last season was somebody that didn't have a great pocket presence, someone that doesn't have great throwing mechanics. It's really herky-jerky. He doesn't really use his hips, and he doesn't really have great sequencing. He really tries to muscle the throw, and it just leads to inaccuracies down the field, inconsistencies. He's got a pretty decent deep ball from time to time, but I just don't think that Howell is the type of guy that's going to be a true quarterback one for a franchise in the National Football League. The Commanders are telling teams right now that he is going to be their starting quarterback next year. I'm not sure how much I believe in that, because I think right now for Washington, you can't afford Sam Howell to not be good. You need whoever the quarterback is going to be for the Commanders next year. Ron Rivera needs them to perform. The NFC East had three playoff teams in the NFC in 2022. The Commanders need to win, and they need to win now to save Ron Rivera's job. And, you know, hitching his wagon to Sam Howell, a fifth-round pick that's barely gotten any action, and that action came against arguably a preseason-style defense, I'm just not sure if that's something that the Commanders are going to be willing to do. So if they want to go get somebody on the trade market or the free agent market or maybe in the draft, one of the biggest names that is out there right now is Lamar Jackson. Now, it's expected that the Ravens are going to franchise tag him, so it's looking like if Lamar is going to get traded, he's going to have to essentially ask for a trade, and plain and simply, it's going to cost the Commanders a lot to get Lamar Jackson because they don't have a premium pick right at the top of the draft like, say, the Colts. They're going to have to give up pretty much close to what the Browns gave the Texans for Deshaun Watson. So this is what a potential trade package would look like if the Commanders were to go get a guy like Lamar Jackson. Probably three first-round picks, including the 16th overall pick this year, and then the first-rounder for the next two seasons, a fourth-rounder this year, and then a third-rounder next year. So if I was Washington and I had an opportunity to get a guy like Lamar Jackson, if I was Ron Rivera and my job was on the line heading into 2023, I had to win, I would make this trade. I would absolutely burn the boats here and get the guy that would be arguably the best quarterback in the NFC right when you trade for him. Right when you trade for Lamar Jackson, you have the best quarterback in the entire conference, and you got some good pieces on defense, especially on the defensive line. You got some good receivers for Lamar to work with. Lamar, in my opinion, is a better pocket passer than people give him credit for. I think that this is a move where if you have the opportunity to go get a superstar quarterback like Lamar Jackson, you absolutely have to make this trade if you are the Commanders. But do you agree with me? Let me know in the comment section right now. Are you making this trade? That includes three first-round picks and then a couple of mid-round picks for former MVP Lamar Jackson. Type yes or no in the comment section right now. I cannot wait to see what your thoughts are on this trade.